Good evening, students. Tomorrow we have first year syllabus chapters. So mainly the living world. So we'll begin with the first chapter of the PUC first year syllabus, the living world. First question: binomial nomenclature means, you know that Carolus Linnaeus, the father of what you call taxonomy, modern taxonomy, who has proposed this binomial nomenclature. So what is this binomial nomenclature? Scientific naming of an organism using two word name. Take for example human being, we have two words, Homo sapiens. So the first word is a genus name whose initial letters start with capital letter, and the second name is the species name or specific name whose initial letters start with small letter, right? So according to this, a scientific name which consists of two words giving a generic name and a specific name, that is the answer for binomial nomenclature, right? Next, now binomial nomenclature was first issued in, you know that Carolus Linnaeus has given different books, published different books, Philosophia Botanica, Systema Naturae, Genera Plantarum, Species Plantarum. These are the four books which were published by Carolus Linnaeus. Remember, actually binomial nomenclature regarding this, it was introduced in Philosophia Botanica, but that option is not there. Okay, so binomial nomenclature was first issued for plants in Species Plantarum in 1753, and for animals in 1758, Systema Naturae. So for plant it was given first, so it is published as, or it was published as Species Plantarum. So we will go with fourth option, Systema Naturae for animals. Okay, it was for animals, it was in the year 1758, valid scientific name for plants beginning 1753, then Systema Naturae in animals, right? So it is Species Plantarum. So we have a book the taxonomist by name Conrad Jessner, he gave a book by name Historia Plantarum. Now that is Historia Animalium. Historia Animalium. This was given by Conrad Jessner. Next, the basic unit of classification is, so you have different what you call taxon. You have different taxon: lowest, basic, species, genus. Then you have family, order, class, division in plant, phylum in animal. Then lastly you have kingdom. So these are seven obligatory taxons which are used in the classification of any organism, plant or animal. Okay, basic lowest, simplest unit, species, then genus, family, order, class, division or phylum, kingdom. Okay, complexity goes on increasing, and the number of characters, similarities, similarity decreases from bottom to top. This is ascending from species to kingdom, that is ascending. From kingdom to species, that is descending. So when you go ascending from species to kingdom, number of similarity characters decrease. Kingdom to species, number of what you call similarities will go on increasing. Okay, so this is what you call species. Okay, see, second question, in some book they have given Systema Nature. I agree with Mr. Nagesh Gadwal, but the year published I am taking here, Species Plantarum 1753, Systema Nature 1758. So that's why I have gone for Species Plantarum. Actually, the concept of binomial nomenclature was the first given in the book Philosophia Botanica. That option only not there in this. So that's why I went for Species Plantarum. In some of the book, they have given Systema Nature. I agree with that. Next. What is the size of herbarium sheet and label recommended generally? So you know, herbarium sheet used in taxonomic studies. Okay, dried, pressed, preserved sheet containing a particular plant part like this. Okay, this is 29 centimeter. This is 41 centimeter. Okay, then this labeling at the bottom here, 7 centimeter. This is 14 centimeter and this is 7 centimeter. Here plant name, English name, scientific name, then family, date of collection, place of collection, name of the collector. Okay, complete details will be given in this label. Okay, so we will go with the second option. The genus Felis include, includes cat. Okay, tiger, panthera, panthera tigris, panthera leo, panthera parados, that is what you call panther. Next, who had written Systema Naturae? Carolus Linnaeus. That remember, Ernest Mayr, Darwin of 20th century, taxonomist, evolutionist. He has worked in the field of taxonomy and evolution. You know about R.H. Whittaker. R.H. Whittaker, what he has done, an American ecologist, he gave five kingdom system of classification. Then W.M. Stanley. What is his contribution? Anybody can tell? W.M. Stanley, he isolated pure crystalline form of TMV, tobacco mosaic virus. That is the contribution of W.M. Stanley. The term taxonomy was introduced by, a French. His name is A.P.D. Candolle. Okay, so that is the first option is the answer. You know about Bentham and Hooker, they gave natural system of classification. Okay, they published the book Genera Plantarum, right? And you know about Julian Huxley coined the term protoplasm as physical basis of life. That is the contribution of Julian Huxley. Third name in trinomial nomenclature indicate. Usually we are following binomial nomenclature. There are some exceptions. Which are having what you call three names. Okay, so say for example, gorilla. It sounds like echo. Gorilla. So here, genus, species, and the last one, that is subspecies. Okay, in case of plants, some are there. That third word, we can call it as variety. You have Brassica oleracea botrytis. Like this, you have one scientific name, genus, species, and botrytis is variety. Okay, so this cabbage, cauliflower, you know, so light difference will be there in the scientific name, mustard family, Brassica oleracea botrytis. Here in plant we call it as variety. In case of animals, that third name we usually call it a subspecies. Ascending or descending arrangement of taxonomic categories is known as, so what you call this, you call it as hierarchy. I guess, no, that species to kingdom or kingdom to what you call species, that is hierarchy. The arrangement of various taxon either in ascending or descending order in the classification of an organism, that is called as hierarchy. This hierarchy was used first time by Carolus Linnaeus. Okay, then taxonomy, the branch of biology which mainly deals with characterization, identification, naming, and classification of organism. You know that. So key is an taxonomic aid. It is a taxonomic aid. Okay, the scheme for identification of plants and animals based on similarities and dissimilarities. Okay, so it is based on set of contrasting character. That contrasting character, what you call couplet, and each character of a couplet is called as lead. Key is usually analytical in nature. It is analytical in nature. Okay, when a set of contrasting characters are there for a trait, okay, it leads to acceptance of one. We accept one set of character, we reject another set of character. That is about a key. That was used by genre. The term was used by genre. Which taxonomical aid provide all information about particular taxon like order or family? Okay, so the book which gives information about various aspects of biology, including the taxonomy of a taxon. Taxonomy of a taxon. So what can be the answer here? Right, fourth option is right. So which taxonomic aid provide all information about particular taxon? That is monograph. It is right. Okay. Rajkumar Bainur is asking, what about remaining second year syllabus? Remaining chapters over, no? See, organism, population, ecosystem that we have in botany syllabus. Then in zoology, you have what you call that biodiversity and conservation and environmental issue that will be covered in zoology. Remaining all we have covered, no, Rajkumar? Why you are in confusion? Yesterday, due to that Karnataka band, that curfew, what you call ecosystem, we could not discuss. Otherwise, we have discussed all chapter of second year. I don't know why he is in confusion. Okay, just to go through the syllabus, we will come to know. All chapters we have covered. Today onwards, we are covering the first year syllabus. 11 chapter, Living World to Plant Growth and Development. Okay, so you know about herbarium. Herbarium is a taxonomic aid where pressed, dried and preserved plant specimens are kept on a herbarium sheet. It is used as a quick reference for taxonomic studies. Catalog, list of systematically arranged plants and animals. List of systematically arranged plants and animals with a brief description that helps in their identification. And I told about taxonomic key scheme for identification of plants and animal based on similarity and dissimilarity. Next, identify from the following the only taxonomic category that has a real existence. Real existence means it can produce young one, interbreeding individuals which can interbreed and produce the young ones. So which one that? Yes, Mr. Kalaling and others query are correct. Species, the basic unit of classification. Okay, the structurally and functionally closely related individuals which can interbreed among themselves to produce fertile young one. Okay, Rajkumar, Mr. Rajkumar, ecosystem yesterday due to Karnataka curfew, we could not come and discuss. Is it or not? Ecosystem chapter on that you might have written today, test now. Other day, okay, when we will get time, we will discuss ecosystem also. You don't worry. But yesterday I posted ecosystem, that's okay, you need not worry. We'll discuss. Huh? Now, as per the schedule, tomorrow Living World is there. That's why I'm covering Living World. You don't worry. One fine day, we will discuss ecosystem also. Okay. Genus, the group of related species. Okay. Phylum, the group of related class. Then phylum in animal and division in plant. Kingdom, highest taxonomic category, largest taxonomic category. The group of several related division or phyla. It is called as kingdom. You know, we have mainly over Monera, Protista, Mycota, all that you know about. Biodiversity can be best defined as the sum total of living organisms on earth, the total number of plants and animals found on earth, that you can call it as biodiversity. So you see what can be the answer here. On earth we have to take ecosystem, means it is a small area, you should not take ecosystem. Total, sum total of life on earth, the number of variety of flora and fauna found on earth, that we can call it as biodiversity, right? So what can be the answer here? First one, occurrence of number and type of organisms. Occurrence of number and type of organisms, particularly on earth. Okay, ecosystem means a particular region. We cannot go with this variety of life in an ecosystem. okay, ecosystem after ecosystem you have what you call a biome, you have then biosphere you have. So total life found on earth nothing but biosphere, atmosphere, lithosphere as well as hydrosphere. Wherever we find life, that we can call it as biodiversity. So we'll go with the first option. Okay, where was the first herbarium set up? So herbarium preparation has started very long back itself. Okay, so it was first set up in Italy, Pisa, Italy. You know about that Royal Botanical Garden, Kew, London. There, one of the largest herbarium collection is there. Next, the framework system of classification in which various taxonomic categories are arranged in order of logical sequence is called. Question twisted, answer same. Hierarchy. What is hierarchy? Framework system of classification in which various taxonomic categories are arranged in order of logical sequence from lower to higher or from higher to lower. So that is called as hierarchy. Systematics term was used by Carolus Linnaeus. Carolus Linnaeus has used the term systematics. Okay, it is a study of what you call diversity of organism based on evolutionary relationship. Study of diversity of organism. Diversity of organism based on what you call evolutionary relationship is known as systematics. Okay, classification is grouping of organism into convenient category based on easily observable character. Based on easily observable character. Taxon. Taxon is unit of classification. Unit of classification. Plural, we have taxa. We have taxa. Okay. Next, the group of organism with similar trait of any rank. The group of organism with similar trait of any rank. Very simple one. What it is? Any rank they are asking. So we have to go with unit of classification of any rank it is. So we'll go with first option. Which one is species? So which is species here? See, identify. Canis, genus. Okay, dog comes under this. Okay, P, Pisum sativum. Leo, Panthera, Leo. Leo is what you call it? What it is? Species. Carnivora. Carnivora, what this carnivora? Carnivora is order. Okay, so we will go with what you call third option here. Right. A species is a group of organisms which, very simple one you see there, can interbreed freely. Is it or not? A species is a group of organism which can interbreed freely. Right. Next now, one of the most important functions of botanical garden. Botanical garden also taxonomic aid. See, they interbreed among themselves to produce fertile young ones we call species. There may be some exceptions which may not reproduce. Mule is there. Okay, then worker, that bee, then infertile human being after even after several years of marriage, they don't have child. So that can be what you call infertile case. Always we cannot say that through reproduction fertile young ones can be produced. Sometimes there may not be reproduction also. One of the most important functions of botanical garden is, so which one here? Okay, they allow ex situ conservation of germplasm. So ex situ outside in the open conditions, okay, in the open condition, not near the mother place. So there, what you call the plants can be cultivated for taxonomic studies and for what you call conservation, especially endangered species. Endangered species, the plant number which is less, so such plants can be conserved. They are cultivated, they are grown in botanical garden for study, for taxonomic reference. Okay, so it is second option is right. Reproduction is synonymous with growth in which of the following organisms? Unicellular organisms, you have to identify their unicellular organisms. Bacteria, unicellular algae, and amoeba. They mainly multiply by fission. So their reproduction is synonymous term with what you call growth. Solanum and Panthera are Solanum nigrum McCoy, Solanum melongena, Solanum melongena Brinjal, Solanum tuberosum potato, Panthera, it is also genus. Solanum is genus, Panthera also genus. Here Leo, lion, tigress, tiger, paradas, that is what you call it, panther, cheetah. Next, the term species was coined by genre. Aristotle, father of biology, father of geology. You know about Engler and Prandtl, German biologist. Adolf Engler and Karl Prandtl, they followed artificial system of classification. What they followed? Artificial system of classification. They followed and they published the book Dinaturalicon, Flengen, Familian, artificial system. They followed and they have published a book, Dinaturalicon, Flengen, Familian, natural order of the what you call plants. Genre, species, genus, family. These three taxon term was coined by genre. Linnaeus, he used what you call class, order, class terms were used by Linnaeus. Division term, Eichler, phylum, Couvert, phylum term used by Couvert. Then kingdom term used by ICBN, International Code of Biological Nomenclature. Choose the correct sequence in the hierarchy of taxonomic categories in descending order. In descending order means from highest to lowest. See there, simple one, you can get very easily. Highest to lowest you identify here. So it can be, yes, Thor is right, fourth option, right. Division, class, order, family, genus, species. This is the descending order, right? Ascending means species, genus, family, order, class, division, kingdom, right? binomial nomenclature means that every organism has, simple one. So what it has? One scientific name consisting of generic and specific epithet. Scientific name are printed, okay, and derived from. So scientific names are printed in italics and derived from Latin language. Right, okay. So when it is printed in italics and okay, when handwritten, what you will do? You will underline. Is it or not? When it is handwritten, you will underline. What is the basic unit of classification? Very simple one. You know that species is the basic unit of classification. Next, largest herbarium in India. Largest herbarium in India. It is second option. Central National Herbarium, okay, Indian Botanical Garden, Sippur, Howrah, right? National Botanical Research Institute is there in Lucknow, that is correct. Forest Research Institute, Dehradun, this is also Madras Herbarium, Coimbatore, all correct. But largest botanical garden, you know, Indian Botanical Garden only, here only we have largest collection. More than 1 lakh herbaria collection are there. Scientific study of diversity of organism and their evolutionary relationship is, I told, Carolus Linnaeus has coined the term diversity of organism based on evolutionary relationship, I told. So what can be the answer here? Systematics. Morphology, you know, study of external features of plants. Anatomy, internal structure of plant. Taxonomy, you know about that. Identification, naming and classification of organism. A taxa, T-A-X-A, taxa, differ from taxon due to. Taxon is singular, taxa is plural. So what can be the answer here? See, being higher taxonomic category than taxon, wrong. Being lower category, wrong. Being plural of taxon, 28.3. Which of the following are considered as a twin characteristics of our growth? So which are the twin characteristics of growth? Response to stimuli, no. Living property, increase in mass, fine. Increase in number of individuals, right? Increase in number of individuals, number of cells, correct. Increase in width, not there. So second and third means it is 29.3. Increase in mass and increase in number of cells. When increase in number of cells are there, automatically increase in mass will be there, right? Taxonomic hierarchy refers to. So what does the taxonomic hierarchy refers to? First statement, you see, stepwise alignment of all categories for classification of plants and animals. Group of senior taxonomists. List of botanists, zoologists, wrong. Classification of a species based on fossil record, wrong. So 30th will be first option. 30th will be first option. Stepwise alignment of all categories for classification of plants and animals. See properly now. Dash is a collection of dressed, dried, preserved plants. Dash labeled, arranged systematically for further reference. So see there properly now. Dash is a collection of dressed, dried, preserved plant. It is herbarium. Okay, we have to choose between first and second. Now, incorrect. Then a group of closely related species of organism represent, okay, genus. This is also correct. The term systematic was coined by Dick and all wrong. It was coined by Linnaeus. So what can be the answer here? 1, 4 and 5. So it will be third option. It will be third option. Biosystematics aims at, so what is biosystematics here? The classification of organism based on their evolutionary history and establishing first option. So first option is right. Remaining identification and arrangement of organism on the basis of their cytological characteristics. Classification based on broad morphological character, delimiting various taxa of organisms and establishing their relationship. These are all not correct. Next, ICBM stands for, see that properly, International Code for Botanical Nomenclature, second one. If this option is not there, International Code for Biological Nomenclature, we can go Biological Nomenclature. Then one more is there. What is that? ICZN. ICZN is for International Code for Zoological Nomenclature. International Code for Zoological Nomenclature. Next, in the majority of higher animals and plants, reproduction and growth are higher animals. They are asking, they are exclusive events, is it or not? Reproduction will give rise to young one, but later on young one will become adult due to growth and development, whereas in unicellular organism that is inclusive. Here it is higher animal. So mutually exclusive events. Growth and reproduction are synonymous in unicellular organism, bacteria, all that. Dash is a book which contained information about habitat, distribution, climatic description, and index of plant found in a particular area. Yes, Flora is right. The book which contain information about what you call the plants found in an area, their habitat, distribution, climate, description, and index of plant, right. I have told about the monograph, I have told about key manual, the book containing information for identification of name of organisms or species, names of organisms or species. Read the following features and select the correct option from the options given below with respect to living beings. So living being, they are asking, they reproduce, correct. They metabolize, they show metabolic reaction, anabolism, catabolism, correct. They have cellular organization, they are made up of cells, okay, basic functional unit. They have the ability to respond to the stimuli. All the characters you will find in living organisms. So we will go with all are true. Different groups of ranks or levels in classification is known as, what it is known as? Taxon. Taxon, different group of rank or level in classification is known as taxon. The suffix phyta indicates, so what it indicates, suffix phyta? division, order ails, division, fight. Take for example, chlorophyte, bryophyte, pteridophyte. So like that, these different division order, especially in plants, ails, sapindales, polymoniales, rose ails, like that ails. Class Phyci, Phyci, Chlorophyci, Rhodophyci, Pyophyci. Class in higher A dicotyledone, monocotyledone, dicotyledone, monocotyledone. Family AC, Solanaceae, Liliaceae, okay, Fabaceae, like that we give suffix ending name, prefix starting. So division usually end with phyta, remember. Which of the following taxonomic ranks contain organism most similar to one another? Lower the taxon, most similarity of the characters, that you know. So which is the lowest unit you identify here? Which one is the lowest unit? Right, species is the lowest unit. Right, species, the group of structurally and genetically identical individuals which get interbreed among themselves to produce the fertile young ones. Cell division occur in dash plants and dash in animals. So cell division can occur continuously in plants and up to certain age in animals. Up to certain age in animals. Okay, so we will go with which option? First option. Right, if you have answered. Even in unicellular organism with respect to growth and reproduction, following can be true. So which is the true? You see, growth and reproduction are inclusive events, correct? In unicellular, they are telling unicellular organism grow by cell division, correct? Okay, both are exclusive, wrong. This is in higher animals, higher plants. So it is both 1 and 2, correct? So we will go with the third option. Non-living objects, see carefully there, non-living objects grows from external surface by collecting substance on it, correct? Due to the addition of material from outside, there will be increase in size. So these non-living things, say for example, you have stones like this. If you add the few more stones, then this heap size will increase. Due to the addition of materials from outside, the size will increase. This kind of growth seen in non-living, that is called as accretion. In case of living organisms, in case of living plants and animals, it is called as intussusception. It is called as intussusception. Okay, grows from internal surface like living. No, intussusception is from inside, the growth from inside. do not grow at all. Non-living also can grow in size when there is addition from outside. Can grow. Wrong. So which option here? First option. Only one is correct. The fungi, the filamentous algae, the protonema of Mars, all easily multiply by budding yeast, hydra, you know that, yeast, hydra, then fission, binary fission, bacteria, amoeba, euglena, different example, regeneration, you can give planaria, starfish, okay, this regeneration. Answer is fragmentation. Answer is fragmentation. The fungi, filamentous algae and protonema of moss, mainly by fragmentation, they can multiply. Next, which of the following factors exclusively affects reproduction in seasonal breeders, both plants and animals? So the day length, night length, it determines the reproduction, flowering in plants, all that. So we'll go with here, which one? Third option, photoperiod. The number of hours of light available in a day. The ability of plants or animal to detect the day length. That is photoperiod. That is responsible for mainly reproduction and flowering, all that in living organisms. So we'll go with fourth option. Which of the following term is used to refer the number of varieties of plants and animals on earth? Number of varieties of plants and animals on earth. It is biodiversity. It is biodiversity. Each category of taxonomic hierarchy referred to as, each category of taxonomic hierarchy refers to as a unit of dash. So what it is, unit of not nomenclature, unit of classification it is. It is unit of classification. Each category or taxonomic hierarchy refers to as unit of classification. Taxon is a unit of classification. Next, taxon is a 47-48 related. Taxon is a unit of classification. Next, 49. The practical purpose of classification of living organisms is to, practical purpose. Read carefully there. Read carefully, then you will get. Explain the origin of living organism. Now, origin, all that evolutionary aspect. Trace the evolution of living organism. Evolution, ancestry, tracing. Okay, this is also not there. Name the living organism, that is nomenclature, naming. Facilitate identification of unknown organism. 49.4. Okay, unknown organism we have to identify, then we can give the name, then we can group them into convenient category. So fourth is more correct. Yeah. Families are characterized on which of the following features of plant species? Families, which characters are considered? See there carefully. External morphology, anatomy of parts, vegetative and reproductive parts. This is the correct third option. Vegetative, nothing but morphological character only, but reproductive parts were also considered here. So third option is right. Which of the following taxonomic aid provides information for the identification of name of species found in an area? Just few minutes back I have given this definition. Identify, it is one of the taxonomic aid. So it is manual, manual monograph, taxonomy of one taxon, flora, the total plants found in a particular area. Okay, periodicals also will be available in library, all that. Okay, next. Which one of the taxonomic aids can give comprehensive account of a complete compiled information of any one genus or a family at a particular time? So taxonomy of a taxon. So what can be the answer here? Monograph. Monograph is the answer here. Taxonomic key, flora, herbarium already out told. Herbarium is a, so what is this herbarium? Garden where medicinal plants are grown, wrong. Garden where herbaceous plants are grown, wrong. Chemical to kill plants, wrong. Dry garden, correct. It is a dry garden because pressed, dried, preserved plant specimens will be there, yeah. Okay, so that's why it is a dry garden, we can call. Keys are generally dash in nature. I told this. Quickly, hot respond to this simple one. Keys are generally dash. Right. Analytical in nature. Correct. They are analytical in nature. I told about key on that. Which of the following statements are correct? See carefully, you will get. Only living organisms can grow, wrong. Non-living things also can grow, no, in size. Plants grow only up to certain age. Plants grow continuously. Animals can grow up to certain age. Okay. Then, the growth in living organism is from inside. Correct. Intersusception. Growth is intrinsic, internal. Okay. So, we will go with third option. All right. Which two points are known as the twin characteristics of growth? Repeated, it is increase in mass, increase in number of individuals. So what can be the answer here? Fourth one. Which of the statements regarding nomenclature is correct? See, the rules are given here. Check properly, you will get it. Generic name always begin with capital letter, whereas specific name with small letter, correct. Scientific name should be printed in italic, correct. Scientific name when typed or handwritten should be underlined, correct. So we will go with here, right. Fourth option is right. Fourth option is right. Which of the following statements are correct about herbarium? See properly, you will get it. Simple one. It is a storehouse of collected plant specimens that are dried and preserved on sheet. Herbarium sheet contain information about date and place of collection, name, family, collector name, correct. Then it serves as a quick referral system for taxonomic studies, correct. So we will go with all of these, right. Which of the following statements are correct? See carefully, you will get it. genus comprises a group of related species. Correct. Taxon represent a taxonomic group of individual organism. It is not individual organism. Taxon is including the group of individuals here, the group of organism. Okay, they are group of organism of any level which have some common character. So second one is not correct. They are group of one or more population or group of organism of any level which have some common character. Second is not correct. Family comprises a group of related genera. This is correct. Group of several related genera, family. Taxonomic category, class include related order. This is also correct. So we will go with third option here. Next, which of the following statements are correct? So which are correct, you see there? All living organisms have the ability to respond to the environment stimuli, which could be physical, chemical or biological. Correct. Plants respond to external factor, light, water, temperature, other organism, pollutant. Correct. Photosynthesis affect the process of reproduction. Correct. Human being is the only organism who has self-consciousness. Correct. So it is fourth option. Right. Next, which of the following taxonomic categories is being described by the given statements? See there, you will get very easily the basic unit of classification. It is defined as a group of individuals which resemble in their morphological and reproductive character and interbreed among themselves to produce fertile offspring. Human beings belong to the species Sapiens, which is a group in the genus Homo. So all these are related to species. Read now, which of the following taxonomical aid is being described by the given statement 1 to 4? They generally established in educational institute. They have collection of preserved plant and animal specimens for study and reference. Insects are preserved in box after collecting, killing and pinning. They often have collections of skeletons of animals too. So these are all related to museum, biological museum, zoological park, the place where wild animals are preserved in open, natural, protective environment under human care. Botanical garden, it is a specialized garden where local and exotic plants are grown for their conservation and taxonomic studies. Next, you see now, which of the following statement is incorrect? Check which of the following are incorrect. The scientific name for humans is Homo sapiens. Correct. Organisms placed in the same genus are least closely. Same genus are least closely related. Wrong. Organisms placed in same genus are having more common characteristics. Least closely they are given. Wrong it is. More similarities, more common characteristics. Then moving from species to kingdom, more different species are included in each category. Right. Complexity increases. It become larger. What you call a taxonomic unit. Species that are rich in same genus share very specific characteristics, right? So 63, 2, dicotyledons like mango, brinjal, and monocotyledons like wheat and rice are placed under a taxonomic category known as which? Mango, brinjal, and monocotyledon like wheat, rice are placed under that is division angiospermae, right? Division angiospermae has class dicotyledonae and monocotyledonae. Polypetal means petals free. Next, among the given taxonomic aids, how many are associated with preservation of plant specimens? Preservation of plant specimen, they are asking. Museum plant specimens can be preserved in jar. Okay, monograph book, flora book, key is also a book based on similarity and dissimilarity. Here live plants are what you call cultivated in botanical garden. Preserving the specimen, they are asking. Okay, catalog is also book. Herbarium, where plant specimens are preserved. Manual also book. Okay, identification of name of species. So it is second, museum and herbarium. These two can preserve the specimens. How it will be fourth, I don't know. Only two. Okay, botanical garden, live plants are cultivated. These are different, they are all publication books. Assertion reason. Read it properly, will get it. The species is a reproductively isolated natural population. Correct. Prokaryotes cannot be kept under different species on the basis of reproductive isolation. These prokaryotes, you know, they multiply by fission. No formation and fusion of gametes. Right. So second one is right. Both assertion and reason are true. But reason is not the correct explanation of assertion. Next one you read now. Assertion. Information given on the label of herbarium sheet does not include family. It includes family. Wrong. Reason. Families are characterized on the basis of reproductive features of plant species only. Not only reproductive feature, morphology, morphological character, vegetative characters are also considered. So this is also wrong. So we will go with fourth option. Both assertion and reason are false. Assertion. Panthera is a polytype genera. Correct. Because it includes Leo, Tigris, Pardus. Reason. Panthera has specific epithet like Leo, Tiger, Tigris, and Pardus. Right. So first option. Reason is the correct explanation of assertion. Next. Assertion. Scientific names for plants have been standardized through ICBM. Correct. International Code for Biological Nomenclature. Naming system which used three-word format was given by Linnaeus. Wrong. Okay. Linnaeus has given binomial nomenclature. So what will be the answer here? 69.3. Reason is false. Rajkumar is right. Others also right. Okay, now math following simple one. See there. Check out. They are given order. Different examples belonging to their order you have to identify. Wheat, whales, mango, sepindales, housefly, diptera, man, primate. See there. A4, B3, C2, D1. So what is that answer? Calling you out is see carefully, others is right. Second option. Next, match the column 1 with column 2. See there, match it. National Botanical Research Institute, NBRI, situated in Lucknow. Indian Botanical Garden, situated in Howrah, Sippur, Howrah, West Bengal. Binomial Nomenclature, Kerala Lineage. Unit of Classification, Taxon. A4, B3, C1, and D2. So what can be the answer here? Right, second option is right. Kala Ling, Siddhanna, Rajkumar, all are correct. Okay, Akash also correct. Next. Which of the following taxonomic category of housefly is incorrectly matched? Which is incorrectly matched? You see there properly now. Yes, RN is right. RN com. So regular second year students are also attending this. Fine, along with crash course students. Fine. Okay. Which of the following taxonomic category of housefly is incorrectly matched? Genus Musca, correct. Species, you know, Domestica. Musca domestica. Family Musidae. Order Primata given. Primata is for human beings. Is it or not? So what is the order here? Diptera. Diptera is order. Is it or not? Is it or not, man? Akash. Order is Diptera. Then class is insect. Right. So third is incorrect here. Right. Right, next, 73, you see, which of the following organism is not correctly matched with its particular? See properly, we'll get it. Simple one. Human beings, sapiens, species, right. Lion, panthera, genus, correct. Then cats, felidae, genus given, wrong. Felidae is, what is that Felidae? Felidae is family, is it or not? It is not genus, right? So third is incorrect, Dathura, Solanaceae family, correct. This is correctly matched. Select the correct match here. See the correct match, print in the table, not dark. I will read. Ex-situ conservation. Ex-situ in the open place, outside open conditions. Royal Botanical Garden, Kew, London. Quick referral system. herbarium, Central National Herbarium. Preserved plant and animal specimens, museum. Account of habitat and distribution of plant in an area, flora. So what can be the answer here? Right, Adarsh is right. Fourth one. Fourth is right. Right. Next you see now. Consider the following diagram and fill the following blank. Taxonomic hierarchy, different taxon in ascending order they are given. From lowest to highest. Very simple one. Check it out. Very simple it is. Lowest to highest. Ascending. Missing box you identify here. A is species. Species, genus, family. After family, what we will get? Order will get. B is order. Class, division. Last one you will get? Kingdom. So what will be the answer here? Second. Right. Second is right. Mahalakshmi Patil is right. Akash, Rajkumar, Adarsh, all okay. Many have done correctly. Right, next. Identify correct sequence of taxonomic categories. Correct sequence you have to identify. Okay, as per the given options, lowest to highest to identify. Lowest to highest. See carefully there. Right, Akash has answered fast. Correct. Fourth one is right. Species, genus, family, order, class, division, kingdom. Right. Fourth is right. Taxonomic hierarchy refers to. So what it refers to, taxonomic hierarchy, see there properly, you will get it. Stepwise arrangement of all categories for classification of plants and animals. Right. Senior taxonomy zoologist all will not come. Sorry, question repeated, I think. Okay, 77.1. The disadvantage of using common name for species is that. So what will be the disadvantage you see there? The names may change, correct? Names will change, common names. And one name does not apply universally. One name is shared by so many people. So many Sachin are there. Okay, so many Aishwarya are there. So names are being shared. One species may have several common names and one common name may be applied to two species. This is also correct, right? So all of these is right. Many have done nicely, correct? Next, the most important feature of all living systems is to check properly there. Most important feature of all living system, all living organisms. See carefully, you will get it. Utilize oxygen to generate energy. Some they don't use oxygen. Replicate the genetic information. Okay, fine. Produce gametes, utilize solar energy for metabolic activity. So we'll go with second option here, replicating. Because the young one, the daughter cells which are produced, they should receive the same copy of the genetic information. So we'll go with second one, replication. Right, some of you have done correct. The common characteristics between tomato and potato will be maximum at the level of their identify. Tomato and potato, common characteristics, at which level maximum common characteristics? Mr. Kalaling is correct here. Second is correct. Okay, because tomato, correct scientific name, Lycopersicum esculentum. Potato, you know, Solanum tuberosum. Genus different here. Solanum lycopersicum. Then they belong to the family. Same family. What is that same family? Solanaceae. Okay. So second is right. Next you see. As we go from species to kingdom in a taxonomic hierarchy, the number of common characteristics lower to higher, common characteristics decrease or increase, that you want to identify here. Common characteristics, when you go higher level, okay, it will go on decreasing. It will go on decreasing. All giving second option here, Rahul Gutyadar, other score. First option, Mr. Bhaskar Reddy Garu and Akash Raj Bainur, you are all correct. Will decrease as we go up, number of individuals, the taxon become bigger, bigger and bigger, large number of individuals, population included, different types. As a result, characteristics become less common there. See there next. If an organism is the same class, see, if an organism is in the same class but not in the same family, then it may belong to. So family and class, in between these two, which one will come? That is the answer. Identify. Taking more time. Fourth, right. Fourth is right. Order, is it or not? See, family, order, class, division. If an organism is in the same class but not in the same family, so then it belongs to the same order. Right. Okay, now question is very lengthy, but answer is simple. Read and find out the answer. Refer the botanical name of wheat, Triticum aestivum, and identify the statement which correctly describes it. Check the answer. Second word belong to genus and start with small letter. Wrong. You know, second word always species. Both the word Triticum aestivum denote the specific epithet. Wrong. One genus, one species, it should be. Is it or not? The first word Triticum denote genus which start with the capital letter. Correct. The first word Triticum denote specific epithet. Wrong. So it is third option. Correct. Many have done correctly. Fine. Which of the following shows the correct example of taxonomic category genus? Genus. See properly, you will get it. See properly, you will get it. Potato, tomato, brinjal belong to Solanum. Correct. Genus. Tomato actually Lycopersicum, but they have given Solanum. Okay, here exception, but it is genus. Solanum is genus. Monkey, gorilla, and gibbon are placed in Mammalia. Mammalia is class. They are asking genus now. Okay. Solanum, Petunia, Datura are placed in Solanaceae. It is family. Mangifera indica, Solanum tuberosum, Panthera leo, they are all scientific name of different organism. So we will go with the first option. Many have given correct answer here. Fine. Next. Okay, see there. Couplet represent choice made between two opposite options, which results in taxonomic key. Identify based on key. Couplet, base of contrasting character. Each character of a couplet, that is called lead. Right, Akash and RN have given correct answer. Acceptance of only one and rejection of other. Right. Fourth, Gunderao Patil is also right. Okay. Okay, Mr. Malkapur, you are also right. You have my name, no problem. Okay. ICZN stands for. Okay, fine. International Code of Zoological Nomenclature. Fine. Who is this third option? Others, Indian Code of Zoological Nomenclature. Why it is Indian? Deleted? Fine. Next. As we go from species to kingdom in a taxonomic hierarchy, the number of common characteristics repeated, I think, will decrease. 871 will decrease common characteristics. Next, which of the following animals or plants is correctly matched with its particular named taxonomic category? Check properly, see properly, will get it. Tiger, tigris, the species, correct. Potato, Solanaceae, a genus, it is family. Solanaceae, the family. Human, primata, the family. Primata is what it is? Order, primata. Housefly, Musca, in order, wrong. It is genus. Musca domestica is genus. So we will go with the first option. Right. Many have done correctly. Okay, Namrata and Shri. Both are correct. Next, which of the following is less general in character as compared to genus? Less general. Right. Rajkumar, very fast you are. Species. Which of the following is less general in character as compared to genus? Because species lowest unit, more number of common characteristics will be there. As we go up, common characteristics decrease. Okay, next now. See now 90, as you say, 90. Which one of the following is not a correct statement? Not a correct statement. Read properly. Botanical gardens have collection of living plants for reference. Correct. A museum has a collection of photographs of plant and animal. Wrong. We don't have a photograph. We have plant and animal specimen. Is taxonomic aid for identification of specimen. Correct. Herbarium houses have dried, pressed, preserved plant specimen. Correct. So 90th, second one. Many have done correctly. Good. So you are recalling, you are remembering, and you are doing well on first year syllabus. Nice. You ought to be perfect with first year syllabus. You inform your friends also, at least to join from next class onwards. We can recall everything. I am covering maximum number of questions possible. The common characteristics between tomato and potato will be maximum at the level of family. It is repeated. Which of the following pairs of organisms reproduce by budding? Already I have told. Right. Second, amoeba. They are giving second option. 92. First. 92, first option is right. Akash giving second option. Amoeba. Why you are deleting now? Okay. So yeast and hydra in second year also reproduction in organism chapter we have learned. Yeast and hydra, amoeba fission, planaria, regeneration. The category class includes related. Right, very fast order, related order, fine. Okay, everyone has given a nice answer. How many times this Hemant will give answer? I don't know. All 1111 he has typed. Okay, but before you mark the answer, read properly and don't do hurry, don't do mistake in biology. Okay, Sneha also correct. Which of the following statements are correct about herbarium? Which are correct? Yes, Akash has given correct answer. It is a storehouse of collected plant specimens that are dried, preserved on sheet. Herbarium sheet can information about date, place of collection, name, family, collector. Correct. Quick referral system. Correct. I think it is repeated. Next. Phenetic classification is based on phenetics. Okay. Numerical taxonomy. Phenetics. Right. Easily observable characters of existing organism. Phenetic classification. Next, you will learn this in Plant Kingdom chapter. Dendrogram, all that ancestry, you will learn. Next, you see, Biosystematics aims at, what it aims at? It is repeated, we will go with the fourth option, right? The classification of organism based on their evolutionary history and establishing their phylogeny, all that, right? Okay, match the column 1 with column 2 now here. Match it. Homo sapiens belong to class Mammalia. Musca domestica belong to class Insecta. Mangifera indica class Dicotyledon, it is dicot plant. Okay, Triticum maestivum, wheat, it is a monocot plant. Okay, so what will be the answer here? Third, right. Other score is right. 97.3 is right. It is not second. Bhaskar Reddy is correct. RN has done mistake here. Next, which two points are known as twin characteristics? Repeated, it is increase in mass, increase in number of individual. Okay, we will go with fourth option. 98, fourth option, increase in mass, increase in number of individuals. Okay, choose the correct one now here. Growth cannot be taken as defining property of living organism. Right. Because some non-living things also will grow due to accretion. Dead organism does not grow. Correct. Reproduction cannot be an all-inclusive defining property of living organism. Correct. Because some are infertile, they don't reproduce at all. No, mule, worker bee, then human couples, then fourth, non-living object is also capable of replicating itself. No, non-living. Correct. Metabolism in a test tube is non-living. It is a living reaction. Okay, it is wrong one here. Right? Metabolism is a defining feature of all living organism. Correct. So, which is the answer here? Second one. Right. Next, now 100. We have reached 100th question. Genus represent. What it represent? An individual plant or animal, collection of plant or animals, group of closely related species of plants and animal. Third is right. 100, third is right. Group of closely related species. Right. Third is right. 101. Which of the following suffixes used for unit of classification in plant indicate a taxonomic category family? Family. We have learned three family. Fabaceae, Solanaceae. You will get the answer easily now. Liliaceae. So what can be the answer here? Right. Third is right. Order ills. Okay. A class. One. One. Which we have this. Division is phyta. Okay, so monocotyledone, we will go with this class here, fourth one only. One is not related here. Okay. The taxonomic unit phylum in the classification of plant is division, right? In plant we use division and in animals we use phylum. Next, botanical garden and zoological parks have. Botanical garden and zoological parks have what they have? Collection of endemic living species only. Wrong. Collection of exotic living places. Wrong. Collection of endemic and exotic living. Right. Endemic means indigenous, within the country, local. Okay. And exotic means foreign species. 103. 3 is right. Okay. Fine. So I will stop here. Right. So in next time we will have biological classification. Okay, tomorrow we will have zoology discussion. Okay, fine.